Hello everyone, Hannibal here, and we are about to play, or I am about to play, probably one of my all-time favorite games. The Mass Effect trilogy is just one that I've loved forever, and I'm super excited for the new one, Andromeda. It's part of the reason why I'm doing this, and also just because I've been planning on doing it for a while now. And now that the whole trilogy is backwards compatible for the Xbox One, it's a perfect time to do it. So, I guess we'll just get right into it. I've played this game a lot, and this particular playthrough, I know there's a million playthroughs of it out there on YouTube, but you know, for me, I love it, so I'm gonna play it, and we're gonna play the whole thing. So I've played this game a million times, and yet I want to make sure that I hit every mission.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database.
I'm gonna play through this entire game,
classified,
and not just the main game.
Requested.
I'm gonna do all the side stuff too, because it's fun, it's enjoyable, and just so I don't miss anything, I do have a sheet in front of me or on my computer that allows me to keep track of everything. I know most of it, but it's just a helpful thing for me. Alright, so let's get into this. Let's figure out what Shepard I want to play. And also, just so you guys know, I will be playing as a Paragon Shepard.
Confirmed.
I can't tell you how many times I've tried to play as a Renegade, and I just can't do it. I can't. I cannot do it. Alright, so I believe John's fine. So
please log in to access your profile.
Here's what happens is I like the way that Shepard looks. I don't mess with him. That's Shepard to me. So but we are going to make my own profile here so we're not just straight initial soldier. In this game, soldier is
please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history.
So the soldier class in this game ends up being kind of boring because you have a lot of just like buff abilities for yourself and not much offensively, so I'm not going to go with the soldier in this one, that's for sure. I have played every single ability class, or I can't remember what it's called right now, but I have played every single class in this game. So definitely have experience. So let's see, we got Spacer, Colonist, or Earthborn. Spacer, both of your parents were in the Alliance military. Your childhood was spent on ships and stations as they transferred from posting to posting, never staying in one location for more than a few years. Following your parents' footsteps, you enlisted at the age of 18. In case you guys didn't know, each of these options do affect, obviously they affect things in the game, but you'll have different missions depending on which one you pick. And also, what it doesn't tell you, but if you played it enough times, you realize that these options affect Paragon and Renegade right off the bat. Alright, so we got Colonist. You were born and raised on Mindwar, a small border colony in the Attican Traverse. When you were 16, slavers raided Mindwar, slaughtering your family and friends. You were saved by a passing Alliance patrol, and you enlisted with the military a few years later. We got Earthborn. You were an orphan raised in the streets of the great megatropolises covering Earth. You escaped the life of petty crime and underworld gangs by enlisting with the Alliance military when you turned 18. So, Spacer, I know if you choose Spacer, you actually have a chance, you can talk to your mom, which is kind of weird. It's a little weird to be, I mean, you're like this hero, you're saving the galaxy, but you get a call from your mom. It's interesting. Probably why most, especially if you read a lot, most books, you never either don't hear the parents or the parents die early. It's just easier to have your hero an orphan. Which is why 2 out of 3 of these are, you're an orphan. So we're probably not going to go Spacer just because it's kind of an awkward thing. I'm not a fan of the whole conversation with mom thing. Earthworn, I'm gonna go Colonist, because Earthworn is kind of more the Renegade option. And also, I'm not a fan of the mission comes along with Earthborn. It, like, sours your reputation a little bit, because these people from Earth, they're like, hey, you used to be in a gang with us, and we'll blackmail, we want to blackmail you into something or other, and, but I, so I'm going to go colonist, and that actually ties into one of the DLCs anyway, the Bring Down the Sky DLC. Did I say DLC? In any case, we'll just move on. Alright, so, psychological profile. We got Soul Survivor, War Hero, or Ruthless. And once again, you got more of the middle ground, Paragon, Renegade. So, we got Soul Survivor. During your service, a mission you were on went horribly wrong. Trapped in an extreme survival situation, you had to overcome physical torments and psychological stresses that would have broken down most people. You survived while all those around you fell, and now you alone are left to tell the tale. War Hero. Early in your military career, you found yourself facing an overwhelming enemy force. You risked your own life to save your fellow soldiers and defeat the enemy despite the impossible odds. Your bravery and heroism have earned you medals and recognition from the Alliance fleet. Ruthless. Throughout your military career, you have held fast to one basic rule: get the job done. You've been cold, calculating, and brutal. Your reputation for ruthless efficiency makes your fellow soldiers wary of you, but when failure is not an option, the military always goes to you first. Alright, so that's more or less the Renegade option here. So we're between Soul Survivor and War Hero, and each one, once again, it doesn't, there's not a mission for each one, but they affect dialogue and obviously your past and what people talk to you about. Soul Survivor, it's you and your squad were attacked by a bunch of, I cannot remember what they're called right now. They're like those, the, man, I'm, that's bad. They're like the giant worms underneath the ground that burst up out of the ground and kill you. Or attempt to. They're, basically, it's only, they're the mother of all, I can't remember what they're called. I'm hating myself right now, but, the original one is on T'Chanka. Any case, so there, and that ties into Cerberus. War Hero ties into the Batarians, because that's the overwhelming enemy force, and Ruthless, I think, is also the Batarian one. But, let's see, so Soul Survivor or War Hero, which one do we want to do here? We're gonna go with. I'm gonna go with Soul Survivor this time around.
Confirm military specialization.
All right, so here's where you pick what class you are, or military specialization is what they're putting it. The soldiers are combat specialists, ideal for the front lines of a firefight. Soldiers get improved health, can train the use of all weapon types. It is helpful, but not necessary in this game. Start with the ability to use medium armor and can specialize in heavy armor. I think they're the only ones that can use heavy. Most of the rest of these are just stuck with light armor. Engineers are tech specialists. Using the holographic Omnitool, they can decrypt security systems, repair or modify technical equipment, disrupt enemy weapons or shields, and heal their squad. Engineers can only use light armor, can only receive weapons training with pistols. Adepts are biotic specialists. Through upgradable implants, they can use biotic powers to lift or throw objects, shield the squad, and disable or destroy enemies. Adepts can only use light armor and can only receive weapons training with pistols. Which is kind of boring, but infiltrators combine combat and tech abilities to specialize in killing or disabling enemies at long range. Infiltrators are trained to use Omnitools, focusing on decryption and offensive abilities rather than healing. They can use pistols or sniper rifles and medium armor. Sentinels combine biotic and tech. Typically, they use biotic abilities and advanced healing skills to defend allies, though they can also disrupt opponents with biotic or tech attacks. They are more efficient at tech and biotics than other classes, but at the expense of combat. Sentinels can only use light armor and receive no advanced weapon training. and the Vanguard. I played a lot of Vanguard. They are biotic warriors that combine biotics and weapons to take down opponents and are especially deadly at short range. They use pistols and shotguns and can specialize in medium armor. What do I want to do? I'm not feeling the infiltrator. They received no advanced weapon training. It's a little scary. I've played Vanguard way too much. Biotic or tech is basically what I'm thinking. Engineer or adept. What's nice is I can choose a different class in the other games. This game is definitely the most unique. Or not unique, but it's very different from the other two games in terms of abilities and how many you have and how they work. Let's go with engineer. And a bonus talent. Shotguns, assault rifle, sniper, lift. Like I said, I pretty much have all this unlocked. Warp, throw. Lift is kind of handy for the big guys. But do I really only want to use pistols the whole game? I actually haven't used assault rifles in forever, so I'm gonna
confirm facial
pick assault rifles. And appearance
profile
is good.
Construction complete.
All right.
Identification confirmed.
So for the difficulty, we're just gonna do normal because this is just gonna be a fun playthrough. I have beat every single game on insanity difficulty. I have every single achievement in every game, so. Like I said, this is just a fun playthrough for me. So I'm just going to do normal auto level up. No. Because I like to choose how my squad levels up. Subtitles. I'll have subtitles on, yeah. Defense only. Auto save. Yes. Alright.
Well, what about Shepard? He grew up in the colonies.
He knows how tough life can be out there. His parents were killed when slavers attacked Mindwar.
He saw his whole unit die on a cruise. He could have some serious emotional scars.
Every soldier has scars. Shepard's a survivor.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
That's the only kind of person who can protect the galaxy.
I'll make the call.
In the year 2148, explorers on Mars discovered the remains of an ancient spacefaring civilization. In the decades that followed, these mysterious artifacts revealed startling new technologies enabling them to travel to the furthest stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They called it the greatest discovery in human history. They called it Mass Effect.
Green.
probably not going to talk much during cutscenes, just to let you know.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emissions sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1500K.
1500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment, so you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead, so that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. Only an idiot believes the official story.
That is the official story. Yeah, I gotta agree with Joker.
They don't send Spectres on shakedown runs.
So there's more going on here than the captain's letting up.
Joker! Status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
I love Joker. He's an amazing part of this game. He's a lot of the humor. Alright.
The captain's waiting for you in the
car. So nobody's gonna really, they're not gonna let you talk to them. At least not yet. Let's talk to Presley over here. That's another thing is like I said, I love these games. I'm gonna go through and talk to just about everybody and go through every dialogue, just because I can. It's fun for me.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down in engineering. Didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
All we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system. Why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
Seems a little fishy.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. Why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihlus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
Yeah, probably.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, sir. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't.
He's also the Arbiter.
Like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
If you're a fan of Halo, you'll recognize his voice.
You don't trust Nihlus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War. Lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
That was a while
ago.
That
was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihlus for that.
No, I guess not. But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board. Especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military. But Nihlus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihlus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
30 years is actually a really short amount of time for just finding out that there's aliens in the galaxy to just how, like, normal this is already. All right, we'll look into it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
Alright, so that's Navigator Presley.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not
Dr. Chakwas.
There's something Nihilus isn't telling us.
The galaxy map, we'll be using that later. Not at the moment, though.
The captain's in charge here. He
alright,
I'll talk.
She's a staple, too. The Normandy isn't
think,
the
man?
Same without Dr. Chakwas.
We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
Only a fool goes looking for a fight, Corporal.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself on a coup. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Yeah, don't do something
don't
stupid,
worry,
Jenkins.
I'm not going to screw this up.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians
don't get attached.
Well,
don't get attached to Jenkins. Just to let you know.
Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the first contact war. As for Nihilus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I hope we get a chance to see him in action. I heard Nihilus took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself.
Well, he is a Spectre.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the council races, like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander.
Don't worry, it'll happen.
Spectre? You're always getting dropped into impossible situations, forced to survive unbeatable odds. Just like you on a coup.
I try not to think about a coup.
Sorry, Commander. I didn't mean to offend you. I respect what you did there. We all do.
Let's not dwell on the past, Commander. Was there something else you needed?
Eden Prime. What's this place about?
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not
because
really
a
sure,
corporal
Commander.
Would know.
Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got a Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
I should go. There's a kind of a joke about that. He says that a lot. Alright, I guess we'll talk to Nihilus.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
Where's Captain Anderson?
The captain said he'd meet me here.
He's on his way. I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise.
Jenkins just told
serene,
me.
Tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
Thank you.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I was gonna say that, but I mean, that's pretty much the same thing. Obviously.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
Why the secrecy?
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime. unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation.
Prothean.
It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is Big Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise. They know more about the Protheans than we do.
I can definitely tell the game looks better.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate.
I should have known.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
Not many could have survived what you went through on Akuz. You showed a remarkable will to live, a particularly useful talent. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Good question.
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite
group. I think Shepard would make a pretty good Spectre.
It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
Or not.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Find out more about
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before
sure,
we
Eden Prime, meant to do the Protheans,
it's
so
a
okay.
peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Sweet. Alright.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished.
Wonder why.
Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society. And without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
What about this beacon?
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like the Council? Just kidding.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable.
The Vatarians.
There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk
Blue
of attacking
Suns?
An Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is
Shadow
right
Broker?
On the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Alright, will do.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from
got
Eden
a lot
Prime,
more
sir.
Difficult.
You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Ashley!
Get down!
We are under attack, taking heavy casualties! I repeat!
developing. We can't. We need evac. They came out of nowhere. We need.
What are those things? And there's that. So they're under attack, and there's this crazy thing coming from the sky.
Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold the 38.5.
I love that little, like, way they made his face express something.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
So as I'm playing this, I'm more or less assuming that you guys already know what's going on. I mean, I'm not going to talk about spoilers too much, obviously, but I've already mentioned some things.
Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
That aren't necessarily as
your team's
big of
the
focus
muscle
in this
operation,
game.
Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihlus, you're coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihlus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
Alright.
We are approaching drop point
paradise. Two. Yeah, no, this game's been out long enough that I'm not worried about spoilers.
Ship perimeter secure, Commander.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Pistols and that. Now this assault rifle is not accurate at all.
Hostiles everywhere. Keep your
guard up.
Alright, it's gonna run me through. Right, so I haven't played it on the Xbox One yet, so it's still running me through all the list of codecs. I'm not gonna read through all the codecs for you. Just. Alright, so let's look at the squad here. This might sound crazy to you, but I'm about to put all three of my points into charm. There's a reason for it. You'll see here in a little while. And I'm not worried about myself for the moment. Let's see, what abilities do I have? Sabotage and overload. Perfect. Nope. I want Alenko. What do I want to give him? First aid. That's important. Sentinel. Pistols. Well, we'll just dump all that into assault rifles for him. He's not as important. Save. I usually run about 6 saves, and then I start cycling through. That's about what I figure is necessary. Alright. Right. I've been playing a lot of Far Cry recently, Far Cry 4, so I'm having to remember some of the controls, like what sprint is. So these things, you never really find out what these things are, but I just, you know, oop, they don't ever attack you or fight you or anything. They blow up pretty easily. That's literally the accuracy. If I zoom in, then it gets better. But it gets pretty wide pretty quick. Alright. Like I said, I know where a lot of this stuff is. Oh, that's. I've played this game so many freaking times. So this will be slightly more accurate. I like blowing those things up, I don't know why. So here's the stupid thing. Jenkins, we go around like two corners. That's all he can do, apparently. Spoiler. What are those? So this is going to be a lot of gameplay here. No, wrong one. There we go. And look at that. I leveled up. Didn't even have to use my gun. Perimeter secure. Alright. Jenkins. I'm sorry.
Rip right through his shields. You're out of chance.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, sir.
Okay, so... really? Caden?
I think we got
Why are you even hurt? So, kind of a pet peeve of mine. I don't like those things glowing, so I'm like always... Alright, yeah, let's... We want to put in some for... Okay, overkill... Engineer... I know I'm kind of spreading out the points, but... Caden... What do we want here? We'll unlock lift for a while. Actually, I'm gonna put in decryption for him. Just in case. Okay, so I keep trying to click on the left stick to sprint. And it's A. Yeah, I know about Minigil. Oh, that's probably why he's injured. See on that thing is terrible. Yeah, I know.
Got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. A lot of bodies.
Wasn't even expecting there to be all these hints, but
I'll try to catch up with you in the digs.
I guess maybe I could turn them off. Let's see. Gameplay. Oh, not gameplay. Tutorials. Off. I don't need them. Believe me. Actually, I wonder. Vibration, yes. Honestly, with this game, the sensitivity is already cranked way up, and I've never really felt the need to change the sensitivity like I do in a lot of games. No, not what I meant to do. That's grenade. I wanted equipment. That's what I want. I'm wondering. Okay, so I don't have any weapon upgrades currently. Do have some more armor. I can't talk. Armor upgrades though. First aid. Shield. Let's go with the shield battery. Caden, he'll get the first aid. That should start healing him, actually. Yep, there it goes. And I have a little extra shields. I kind of tend to prefer the extra shields over first aid. Alright. You can only sprint, like truly sprint, if you're in combat. Hello. Goodbye. Those Geth drones are super easy. Especially on normal difficulty. On Insanity, even those guys were fun to deal with. What's Caden doing? Oh. Cutscene. Ashley Jenkins, everybody. Now we get to fight the real threat. Death troopers. Alright, we're sprinting on here. Why am I using the pistol right now? Sabotage. Perfect.
Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, sir. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
Alright.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Until now.
Tell me everything you know about the Geth.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins. And the beacon.
But that's...
Suddenly every scientific expert in the colony was interested.
That's information in another game you learn.
I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
Oh.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
Okay, good.
I don't know. They set up camp near the beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Before the attack.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
Have you seen Nihilus?
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime. None that I've ever met. Not sure I'd be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turian.
Alright, let's go.
Move out.
Alright, and then... we'll grab... these bad boys. Some more light armor. Clear the codex. Alright, Ashley. Oh, I always do that. Well, actually, I don't. She's the only one that needs that. Cool. Found some light armor that's better than what I have. Oh, right. Oh, I know why. This is Caden. I want it for me. No wonder I was so confused. I'm like, what's going on here? There we go. So I could have sworn I had shields on there. Much better. Alright, Caden, that's the same, but you know what? Oh, interesting. So that's something I wonder if... So the Onyx 1 on Shepard has the N7 armor style to it. But to anyone else, it's what Caden's wearing. That's very cool. I never paid attention to that before. In any case, and Ashley already has better armor than I will ever have. Well, not true. I think I can wear a medium armor. I just haven't unlocked it yet. She starts off with medium. I guess we'll just give her those, since that's the only thing I have left. Shepherd, assault rifles. Okay, cool. Hammerhead. You can knock people down. Radioactive rounds. Cooldown reduction to the target. I'll go hammerhead. I'm not using the pistol right now, so Ashley will give the radioactive rounds to. Throw another save in there. Not that I need it, but alright. Right.
Holding position.
That's fine cover.
Redeploying.
That's follow me. That's stay right here. Let's go there. I usually just have them follow me. Alright. There's Geth down there. Do this. Hey buddy, that's not cool. Grenade. Got him. There's another one right there. Just Caden. Huh. Alright, since I leveled up. Encryption, electronics. Let's throw it in the decryption. Caden, give him a barrier. Sentinel. Not really sure. So with this game, your squad mates, it's very easy to go through the entire game with the same two squad mates. And just never pick another group. And I don't want to do that, simply because that's a little more boring for you guys. But at the same time, there's some squad mates in this game that are, I mean, they're all good. I don't know. I guess we'll just see what happens. Accuracy is just as bad, just overheats faster. I'll give her that. Shotgun, save that. Well, no. We'll give Caden that. Alright. Let's look at the dig site.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Okay. Wait, I think I went the wrong way. Yep. Man, I'm turned around. This is really bad, because I just finished claiming I know this game, like the back of my hand, which I do. It's just been a while. Well, I mean, it's not been that long since I played it either. I just knew I needed to go uphill, and I saw uphill. Believe me, I do actually know what I'm doing. There we go.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh God, they're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
Husks. These guys are... Oh, come on. Die already, will ya? Not good. Not good. Right. I just crouched. Alright. That's the other thing is... These guys are... Explode. Alright. Die.
All targets down.
I keep clicking in the left stick to try and run, and I just crouch. Not good at all. Alright, let's check these things out.
That door is closed.
Decryption. Perfect.
Humans. Thank the Maker.
Hurry, close the door before they come back.
You're safe, don't worry.
Don't worry, we'll protect you.
Thank you, I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone.
You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon?
It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
Well, you know, you're on the right track, buddy.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second, we were gathering up our equipment. The next, we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the destroyers. Bringers of darkness. Heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside. Gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
I've seen a Turian.
You notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him, the Prophet, leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That sounds like our Turian.
Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry, Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
The beacon?
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Awakened the beast.
How about...
Unleashed the darkness.
The Reapers.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
So, I could just punch him right here, which is kind of funny. It's a little extreme, though. No.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
Yeah. Especially since I'm playing as Paragon. Probably shouldn't punch the guy in the face. It is pretty funny though. Now, who is this?
Saren.
Oh, that's who. Hello, Saren.
Nihlus.
Good to see you again.
This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
I like how you, it's like you hear a gunshot right there, too. Every time I crouch, just know that I tried to sprint. My gun was gonna hit him.
Negative contacts, Commander.
Great, and then the door control.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out, we're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
Yeah, you do.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
Just farmers, huh?
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only it was coming from inside your own head.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, it felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the space.
This right here is why I dumped all those points into.
We let them store packages in our sheds.
The charm option.
You're breaking the law, Cole.
You need at least three.
We're not hurting anybody. Hell, most of the time I don't even know what's in the packages. Just thought there might be something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it.
See,
than we
right
will.
There. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to do that.
We're risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that could help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably deserve it more than I do.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
He might have something to do with this whole attack, Cole. We need his name. It's important.
Yeah, okay, you're right. His name's Powell. Works the docks at the spaceport if he's still alive.
All right, thank you.
I have to go.
Good luck.
Nice, all right. Journal. Codex. equipment. There we go. See, look at it. It's not a bad pistol for the start of the game. And then combat sensor for the Lancer. Ow. I keep giving him all this stuff to Caden. Just not what I mean to do. User, get that. And then I get that. I don't know why I can't keep this straight all of a sudden. Well, I might save the sniper rifle for Garrus, actually. Alright. Sure, why not throw a save point on there? Go down and talk to Powell, who we now know is a contact for the smuggling operation going on at the docks. I didn't think there was anything over there. That fire will hurt you. Which is why it's evil that there's something in the middle of that fire over there.
Commander, it's Nile.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait, don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I am sorry, I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Pal. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihilus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform. Probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. There's that damn mothership showed up, and the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I had been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come the Geth didn't find you?
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks. For the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch. We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Forget about him. He's not worth it.
You're lucky the commander's here, pal. Hand over those grenades.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
A lot of Marines died here, Powell. Those grenades could have come in handy. If I were you, I'd think of some way to make it up to them.
Yeah, okay. There is something else I was saving. Could be worth a fortune. Experimental technology, top of the line. Take it. I don't need it. I didn't want anyone to get hurt. Really, I'm sorry.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick.
One minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
All right, we need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Equipment. Make sure I'm on Shepherd this time. Grenades. High explosive. Hydra. All right.
Heading to position.
Yeah, this is. All right, let's do this. That's easier. Here's a nice little trick. There's a bloke down there. A couple blokes. Nope. Boom. They're dead. Easy as that. And then this gets a little fun. Now I actually mean to crouch. For these guys, simply because of I need the accuracy. Crouch here. Another reason why I like to put those charm points into the charm option, because it gets me this nice pistol that comes in really handy early in the game. Did I miss? For some reason, I thought I missed a crate. Oh, there it is, medical kit. Not super important, considering I was full on Medigel, but... Alright, so we'll get this train going. We can go to the beacon. I'm thinking I'll probably finish this mission and call it good for episode 1.
Accept the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
There's the beacon. Commander Shepard, master of disarming bombs.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
I got plenty of time. It comes to when you actually do get sprints because of combat scenarios, it's best to not use it all up, because then you're kind of stuck. If you can just kind of use it in small bursts. To sabotage that. Sniper, sniper, sniper. Yeah. That hurt. Ow, that hurt too. That's not good. That's where the first aid skill also kind of comes in handy in this game, is that it allows you to use your Medigel sooner after you've used it. Because, like, right now, I'll regen some health, but just be easier. Oh, it's almost back. Should be back by the time I'm done disarming. We're close to it. One more, and still way over 3 minutes. There it is. We'll use that. Alright. All bombs disarmed with plenty of time. I mean, the assault rifles in this game aren't bad. Especially once you get, like, the accurate ones, or, like, the Spectre level ones. But some of these ones are like this, like the Lancer, is so inaccurate. Nice. Yep, so we got husks coming at us too. Take out those guys. These are useful to decrypt right in the very beginning of the game. Especially in the beginning of the game, the more stuff you can collect, the better. Just so you have more options, you can have a better chance of getting better gear early on. So you don't have quite so inaccurate or low damage stuff. And also for your armor too, like upgrades for your armor. That's important. So here's the one issue, is if you use one or two, well, two main squad mates the whole game, and they're going to have all the best stuff, and then as soon, if you try and you switch to a different squad mate for one mission, all of a sudden, because you haven't used them in forever, they don't have that good of stuff, and you don't necessarily have the stuff to give them to make them actually to have good stuff. And then, or if you try and spread it out and use a bunch of different squad mates, then you don't necessarily have anyone that has a ton of good stuff. So I mean, we'll just have to see what I choose to do. Hopefully that makes sense. Alright, let's go check out this beacon. Maybe.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
she's sucked into it. Throw her out of there, and now you're stuck.
Shepard!
No, don't touch it! It's too dangerous!
I do like the fact that the different armor and weapons that you're using reflect in the cutscenes. That's pretty cool. Especially for an older game. Saren has an ally.
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy. A human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Anger issues, maybe?
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours.
It's a long time.
Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
Appreciate it.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Of course.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Chief Williams isn't part of the Normandy crew.
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Good.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Alenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
A little upset about the guess, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
Well, you want to talk?
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren. That other Turian. Saren's a specter. One of the best. The living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue.
I'd say he has.
A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Even better.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
We'll stop him.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
Understood, sir.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his specter status.
I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Alright. I'd say that's probably a pretty good place to end it. We're about an hour and a half in, so thanks for joining me in this first part of my playthrough of Mass Effect. I won't just be doing this game, I'm planning on doing the whole trilogy, but obviously you guys start at the beginning, so hopefully you guys enjoyed it. We'll see what happens, obviously, and hopefully I continue to get better doing this. But in any case, I'm just playing this game because I love it, and I hope you guys do too. And thank you for watching.